So we took a look at Twitter users who discuss political topics on the platform, and particularly political topics related to US politics, for example, Obamacare or gun control. In the process, we analyzed about 2.6 billion tweets. Twitter users, when they engage in political discussions on Twitter, they do basically two things. One is they read the positions of their social connections on the platform, so basically what their opinion is about a topic. And the second thing that they do is that they express themselves, their own opinions and positions about the topic. The opinions that Twitter users receive from their social connections on Twitter resemble to a large degree their own positions. This creates a situation that we call echo chamber. That's a situation where basically people who engage in a discussion end up hearing opinions that are basically their own opinions to start with. And this is a slippery slope. It can lead to tribal politics where what side you are on matters more than what arguments or what opinions or what information you have. One thing that we still need to clarify is to what degree the political discussions that we analyzed on Twitter reflect political discussions that happen elsewhere in society. Do they also represent how political discussions take shape and how they occur at a cafeteria or on the street or in our neighborhoods?